Welcome to a lesson on equivalent fractions. In this lesson, we will define equivalent fractions and also determine equivalent fractions. Equivalent fractions are different fractions that are equal or represent the same amount. Looking at these two models here, if we define the rectangle as one whole, this is the model for 1/4, and this is the model for 2/8. Notice how the fractions are different, but the same amount is shaded, and therefore 1/4 and 2/8 are equivalent fractions. The fraction of 1/4 is using a larger piece to represent the amount, and the fraction of 2/8 is using smaller pieces to represent the amount, but the amount is the same. To find equivalent fractions, we multiply and divide the numerator and denominator by the same non-zero whole number. And a couple things to remember, we would only divide the numerator and denominator by a whole number that is a common factor of both the numerator and denominator. And if a fraction does not have any common factors other than one between the numerator and denominator, a fraction is called simplified or written in lowest terms. Looking at our model again, 1/4 is a simplified fraction because the only common factor between 1 and 4 is 1. Again, if we define the rectangle as one whole, this would be the model for 1/2, this would be the model for 2/4, and this would be the model for 4/8. Notice how we have three different fractions, but the amount shaded is the same, so these are three different fractions that are equal, and therefore all three are equivalent fractions.
2 times 2 is 4.
Now starting with 1/2, notice how to get 2/4, we could multiply the numerator and denominator by 2. 1 times 2 is 2. Notice how by multiplying the numerator and denominator by a whole number, what we're doing is representing the amount using smaller pieces. Here we use one piece to represent 1/2. Here we're using two pieces to represent 2/4. But again, both fractions represent the same amount. To go from 2/4 to 4/8, notice how we would need to multiply the numerator and denominator by 2 again. 2 times 2 is equal to 4. 4 times 2 is equal to 8. Again, by multiplying the numerator and denominator by a whole number, we're representing the amount using smaller pieces. If we did want to go from 1/2 to 4/8, notice how we'd have to multiply the numerator and denominator by 4. 1 times 4 is 4, and 2 times 4 is 8. Looking at the fraction of 1/2, because 1 and 2 only have a common factor of 1, 1/2 would be a simplified fraction, or a fraction written in lowest terms. 2/4 and 4/8 are not simplified because 2 and 4 share a common factor of 2, and 4 and 8 share a common factor of 2, as well as a common factor of 4. Let's look at another example. Here we have a model for the fraction of 18/24, a model for 9/12, and a model for 3/4. Notice how in each fraction the same amount is shaded, but we're using different sized pieces. So because we have three different fractions that are equal or represent the same amount, these three fractions are equivalent. Notice how to go from 18/24 to 9/12. We would have to divide the numerator and denominator by 2. 18 divided by 2 is equal to 9. 24 divided by 2 equals 12. This shows that when we divide the numerator and denominator by a whole number to obtain an equivalent fraction, what we're doing is representing the amount using larger pieces. And to go from 9/12 to 3/4, notice how we would have to divide the numerator and denominator by 3. 9 divided by 3 equals 3, and 12 divided by 3 equals 4. Again, this shows by obtaining an equivalent fraction by dividing, we're representing the same amount using larger pieces. Another way to see equivalent fractions would be to use a fraction wall shown here, where the long blue bar represents one whole. So if we take a look at the fraction of 1/2 here, all the fractions that line up along this vertical line would be equivalent to 1/2. 1/2, 2/4, 3/6, 4/8, 6/12, and 12/24 are all equivalent fractions. Let's take a look at one more. Let's look at the equivalent fraction, so let's say 1/4 here. 1/4, 2/8, 3/12, and 6/24 are all equivalent fractions. Let's finish by determining two equivalent fractions for each of the fractions given here. So beginning with 7/8, because 7 and 8 don't share any common factors other than 1, this fraction is simplified, which means the fine equivalent fractions will need to multiply the numerator and denominator by the same whole number. So let's go ahead and multiply the numerator and denominator by 2. Well, 7 times 2 is equal to 14, 8 times 2 is equal to 16. 14/16 is equivalent to 7/8. Now to find the second equivalent fraction, we can use 14/16 or go back to 7/8. And let's go ahead and go back to 7/8. And now let's multiply the numerator and denominator by 3. We can select any whole number greater than 1. Well, 7 times 3 is equal to 21, and 8 times 3 is equal to 24. 21/24 is also equivalent to 7/8. Now looking at our second example, we're given the fraction of 4/12. Because 4 and 12 do have common factors other than 1, this fraction is not simplified, which means we can find equivalent fractions using division or multiplication. So we have a choice here. Let's go ahead and show division for this example. Well, 4 and 12 do have a common factor of 2, so let's divide the numerator and denominator by 2. Well, 4 divided by 2 is 2, 12 divided by 2 is equal to 6, so 2/6 is equivalent to 4/12. 2 and 6 still have a common factor of 2, so let's use 2/6 and find another equivalent fraction to 4/12. So using division, we'll divide the numerator and denominator by 2 again. Again, we could use multiplication, but I do want to show both methods. Well, 2 divided by 2 is equal to 1, 6 divided by 2 is equal to 3, 1/3 is also equivalent to 4/12. We did use division twice here, but we could have just easily used multiplication. Notice how if we multiplied the numerator and denominator by, let's say, 5, just as one more example, notice how we would have 20/60, which is also equivalent to 4/12. I hope you found this helpful.